In the last few videos, we talked about linear independence, we talked about spanning, we talked about bases for vector spaces, and a fair question is, so what? Why does anybody care about a basis? And the answer is that a basis makes a vector space look like Rn. And so you can take everything that you already know about Rn and apply it to an arbitrary vector space. So let's let V be a vector space, and let's suppose we've got a basis consisting of n vectors in that space. Okay, there's our basis. And if you give me any arbitrary vector, well, we know that this basis spans, so you can write that arbitrary vector as a linear combination. And because the vectors are linearly independent, there's only one way to write this. For proof of that, refer to the book. And we say that the coordinates of the vector are the coefficients when you do the expansion. So for example, if we're working in the space of quadratic polynomials, then a natural basis is 1t and t squared, and every quadratic polynomial is something times 1 plus something times t plus something times t squared. And if I gave you the vector 1 plus 3t plus 5t squared, the coordinates would be 1, 3, and 5. Now, I really should say the coordinates of V in the B basis, because different bases will give rise to different coordinate systems, and it's switching between them that is at the heart of this course. Okay, so our notation is that if I have a vector and I put brackets around it and a subscript, where the subscript is the name of the basis, then that means the coordinates of V in the B basis. So our vector space looks like Rn, because to every vector in the vector space, we associate a list of coordinates. And that list of coordinates, that column, is an element of Rn. So our mantra is a basis makes an n-dimensional space look like Rn. Now, if you add two vectors and then take their coordinates, well, that's just adding the coordinates. And if you rescale a vector and take its coordinates, that's just rescaling the coordinates. And in general, if you do linear combinations and then take coordinates, that's the same thing as taking coordinates and then applying a linear combination. The coordinates of 3x plus 5y are going to be 3 times the coordinates of x plus 5 times the coordinates of y. And what that means is that whenever you've got a question, you've got a bunch of vectors in V, and you're wondering, do they span? Are they linearly independent? Do they satisfy the equation 3 times the first vector plus 5 times the second vector equals 17 times the third vector? Any of these equations you convert into a question about Rn by just computing the coordinates of all the vectors and then asking that question in Rn. So for example, suppose we're looking in the space of quadratic polynomials. I ask you, we've got three functions, the function 1, the function 1 minus t plus t squared, and the function 3 plus 5t plus 3t squared. You wonder, do they span R2 of t? If I give you an absolutely arbitrary polynomial, can you write it as something times 1 plus something times this function plus something times this function? And the way we solve it is by using the basis 1t t squared. And that basis makes the space of quadratic polynomials look just like R3. The coordinates of the function 1 are 1, 0, 0, because it's 1 times 1 plus 0t plus 0t squared. The coordinates of 1 minus t plus t squared are 1, negative 1, 1. The coordinates of 3 plus 5t plus 3t squared are 3, 5, 3. And so using these coordinates converts this question into the question of, do these three vectors span R3? And how do we check that? Well, we package them into a 3x3 matrix and we row reduce. We do a row reduction and hey, we've gotten it into row echelon form. There are three pivots. There's a pivot in each row, so they span. These three vectors span R3. So these three vectors span the space of quadratic polynomials. Last bit is on the size of a basis. If you have a basis with n vectors in it, you can't have more than that many vectors that are linearly independent, because their coordinates would be too many vectors in Rn, and they wouldn't be linearly independent. If you have too few vectors, they can't span, because their coordinates wouldn't be big enough to fill up Rn. So every basis of V has the same number of vectors. If V has one basis with five vectors, then every basis of V has five vectors. And then we say that V is five-dimensional, and it behaves just like R5.